Hello friends, welcome back. We have a new practical, installation and configuration NFS server. Before we start NFS server, let me tell you what is NFS. NFS stands from the network file system, helps you to share files and folder between Linux and Unix system, developed by the Sun Micros in 1990. Our environment, this is our environment. This is our host name of the server and IP address of client and IP address and host name of the client. So this is our lab. You get be familiar with this before we start our practical, because once we will start our practical, I don't want you get confused, guys. The important services, RPC bind. This is the most important services. RPC bind server convert RPC program numbers into universal address. The NFS server is enable the client to access NFS server and NFS lock and RPC state. NFS file locking and implementing file locking recovery when NFS server crash and reboot. And NFS ID map, it translates users group IDs into names to translate user group names into IDs. Important file configuration. It is the export file. It is the main configuration file control. Which file system are export to remote host and specific option. It is FS type. This file is used to control what file system, including NFS directory, are mounted when the system boots. And it is sysconfig NFS. This file is used to control which ports the required RPC services to run on. And etc host allow and host deny. These files are called TCP record, control the access to NFS server, and it is used by NFS to decide whether you're not to accept the connection coming in from another IP. So this is my server. Okay guys, let me show you guys. This is the NFS server, you can see that, right? On NFS server, what we need to do? This is our important configuration file. Preparing, what is the prerequisite? VM should be configured, SC Linux should be disabled, and IP table should be disabled, and port 2049 should be enabled. Connectivity should be enabled between both NFS server and client server. These are the requirements before we start our NFS server. Installation of the NFS server, we have to run this command this package for installation of NFS server. Yum y install nfs hyphen utils lib nfs id map, right? This backend gonna install now. And what is next? After once installed, we have to start and enable etc RPC bind and NFS server, and then start RPC bind, NFS server, start RPC state, and start NFS ID map. Okay. First, we have to start enable RPC bind, and then we have to NFS hyphen server. Then we have to start. Make sure you do this in a sequence. Don't start on NFS server before RPC bind. It will not start. You will get app. Start NFS hyphen server. RPC hyphen SDA state. And then NFS hyphen ID mapd, right? These are our services. Creating a directory. We are going to create. Let's create a directory to share with the client server. Here we will be creating a new directory name share in a slash partition. Note: you can also share your existing directory with the NFS. It is not required that you have to upload a new directory. You can share your existing directory also. Run this command, create a directory, mkdir/share. We have to run this command to give us a full permission. Full permissions. We have to give the full permission, 777, sure, so that other users, other servers, when Swayo and NFS client mount this directory, can create file and directory also. Then we have to modify the configuration file, etc export file. In etc export, you can open in your favorite editor, and we will open etc export file, and this is writing the below entry slash shared and IP address, and this slash shared is a mount point which we want to share the directory. You can say the IP address is the client IP address who want to access. Here we can give a host name also, we can provide a complete network also, right? And RW, it is a read write permission. We are going to share a directory with the write and read permission, sync and not root sequence. This is a command which is a root sequence, so that why we going to use it. Whenever we share NFS server, and without this, if any client create any file and directory in NFS shared folder, and when you will check ls-ltr, you can see nobody, the permission of the file and directory. So when you write this no root sequence, it will not be nobody, then it will be root and root. So when any of client access this directory, this permission allow him to be override like as a root, right? He would be a root, okay? And whenever he create any directory, the file and permission will be root and root, okay? After that, we have to run this command. It is export fs-r. What does it mean? I will tell you in detail. Just bear with me. Okay, now first we have to go etc exports insert share 192.168.10.170 no read or sync comma no underscore root comma sqlubs root request, right? We copy this, right? And we have to run this command etc export fs -r. In the tail end, etc export -v displays a list of shared files and export option on the server. A, export all directories listed in the etc export. U, on export one and more directory. So guys, please be careful before you run -u on your production NFS server. It will unexport all your mount points and directories which are existing shared on NFS server. Export -r, re-export all directories after modifying etc export file. We done -r. Okay, NFS client. So once you will done this, now I will show you one more thing, -e localhost. Now you can see this directory is shared. Okay, now on my NFS client, we need to install NFS package on NFS client server in order to mount remote file system and install NFS package using below command, as we done on our client system. Same we have done our on server, we have done the same thing. Make sure your YUM server is configured. Repo list, it's working properly. It's working properly. YUM by NFS -utils space lib NFS ID map. Oh, my bad guys, forget to install. Okay, now this package is going to install. What should we do next? After this, we have to run etc enable rpc bind, same, okay. Rpc bind start, okay. We have to run only one permission. We have to enable rpc bind and start rpc bind. Just give me a moment. Enable, we are not going to start any NFS server here. RPC enable RPC bind. RPC bind. Great. Now mounting NFS. Before we mounting NFS server, we need to check available shared on NFS server. To do, run the below command on the client side. This you will check is anything shared on mount client. Share mount client hyphen e. And type the IP address 192.168.10.169. Okay, you can see the directory is shared slash shared. Now, as with the command, you can see this. Now we're creating a mount point with the slash shared which we required before on the server. Like I'm going to create one folder share, right? So that we can mount it. Run the below command to create a mount directory. Use the below command to mount the shared directory on the client server. Write mount and the server IP address and colon and the mount point name and where you want to mount the location of that. Right? Like here 192.168.10.169 shared. Yeah, now we can run a command df-kh. Yeah, you can see this is our shared directory in the last line, and then this, and you can run two commands. You can use the mount command and you can use the df command. Okay, now we can see the NFS. Now we have to create one test file so to verify that. Verify the read and write access on our NFS shared, right? Now we run this command. Okay, mount command also you can see in the last this, right? Okay, now go and go to in this shared directory. Okay, there's nothing. Test, we're going to create one file test ls. Right, as I told you, it would be a root, right? And I create one test file. Let's go on my server side. This is my server IP. I'm going on this directory. Ls, wow, the file is also here. I create it from the client side, right? So now you can see this file is on our client side and my server side also. Okay. Now we have to write in the etc fstf file to make it permanent. Open a VA editor with your VA editor etc fstf, write this entry, right, and save and close the file. Now we're going to, so that why I'm writing this, so that after reboot my system come with my mount point 169 shared. There, NFS, comma, read write, comma, comma, hard, comma, INTR, right? And 0 and 0. You guys know it's 0, 0. One is FS check, and another is a dump of your system, your partition. And run this command and unmount this, share. Okay, you are sitting in shared. Why am I unmounting? I want to mount it from etc fstf. So before you reboot system, make sure your whatever entry you've done in etc fstf, that should be correct. Okay. Yeah, valid option. invalid option. Has been NFS invalid option T. Okay, share. Maybe write NFS T. Okay, we did wrong something here, as I told you. We don't need to write here comma, right? Now let me copy it and mount again. Not mounted, mount-v. Yeah, it's successfully mounted now. In the command dhph, you can see in the end of the file it is mounted here. Okay guys, so now you can see that directory is mounted on the server also. So here we already checked that. Okay, now re-verify mount point after reboot. Let's reboot our client machine. We want to check after reboot, does it come up here now without reboot. Okay, I reboot this machine. After reboot the client machine, whether it is automatically run this command to reboot the system. Post reboot, kindly run the below command to verify mount and df. So you will come to know that yeah, mount point is there here now. Okay, we just like restart this. It is not coming up. I just reboot it. It will take a little bit of time. And let me go on my clients. Let me ping the server 10.9.9.1.6.10.1670. Come on. It's coming up. Let's pause the video till it's come up. Yeah, guys, now you can see I just reset this session and let's login. Root a Red Hat. Now run the command dhph. Wow, our this mount point is there. Okay guys, so as this practical is complete, but I want to little extend more advantage of AutoFS. If somebody don't want static mount of atom your mount point, so we can use AutoFS. What are advantages of AutoFS? Shares are accessed automatically and transparently when a user tries to access any file and directory under the designated mount point of the remote system to be mounted. And booting time is significantly reduced because no mounting is done at a boot time. First, we have to install packets with the below command. And we don't need to do this on the server side. We have to do this on the client side only, right? So, on the client side, we have first, let's unmount this, okay? Unmount, share, unmount it, and let me comment it so that file should not be read from here. I write insert this, right? Okay, now you can see run the command -v. Okay, no mount point. Now -df, there is no mount point, right? First we have to install one package, yum install AutoFS. Yum y install AutoFS. Once your package will be installed, we have to configure AutoFS. Open the file auto.master. This is the file we have read this entry /mnt. /mnt is nothing, it is a one empty file. So because we are not going to use it static, so we can use /mnt. Alright, so it doesn't make any difference. Now you also can create one directory where you want to mount it. Okay, like we did and slash shared. But just I want to, you know, give a different example so guys you cannot be confused and you can understand clearly. Slash MNT, I'm giving this directory name, and etc auto msc, this directory should be mounted on the base of whatever we will write in auto.mis hyphen timeout 20. What does it mean? It means if any of your client is not using that particular file, particular mount point for 20 seconds, right, that file will automatically unmount from the client system, because NFS used by to put some files, it never used for any application or something, right? Okay, if you, as per my knowledge, it does not. But if any of your application or team, you know, application team is using NFS as a mount point of application, so I believe you should use a static, you use to static IP, static entries in etc first step. Okay, now we have to open the file etc and auto dot master. You can see in the top, this is the file, right? I copy it and paste it. I'm writing here etc mnt, and I'm giving the instruction that please mount slash mnt on the base of whatever the instruction we have in etc auto.ms and space hyphen hyphen timeout equal to 20. As already told, what does it mean? It means it will automatically unmount when your client system is not accessing that. Okay, I'm going to save it. Right, done. And now I have to open MISC. Right, I open it. Right here, and right here, I'm writing here what I'm going to write. I'm going to write here etc. I'm going right here. I will write here the one only folder name, right? Guys, most of people get confused here. Like, this is a folder, this is a mount point. No, nothing. It is, I'm just, you don't need to create this folder also, right? You have to just write the name where you want to access your mount point. I writing here slash share, right? And hyphen fs tab hyphen equal to my NFS mount point, comma, read write, comma, soft, comma, INDR enter, right? And the my server name, server IP 192.168.10.169 slash shared. Okay, that again, this is slash shared, it's not slash shared, it's just shared. I write it, you can write here Deepak, you can write here Krishna, you can write here anything, right? You can write here Pankaj, you can write here Sunil, you can Jack, Alan, anything. And you don't need to create this directory and this folder on your system. It will automatically create it actually. Okay, like then save this file. Okay, now I have to run command enable auto fs. Right, and one more command, start auto fs. Okay, let's restart it. Yeah, done. Now let me show you guys, there is no mount point which is mounted. Okay, now what I need to do, I am going to, let's, how can you check your mounted? You can see here guys, MNT auto fs on MNT, this is the right timeout 27, right? But when you run the command df-kh, you cannot see anything, right? But now I'm going in MNT folder. Now again run the command. Oh, there's no mount point yet. If you remember, and even here ls, you cannot see anything here, nothing. But you know Your team, your manager, your technical guy will tell you, you have to go in that directory and write this name, and you will automatically access that file, right? I will write in here shared. Wow, even there is no directory shared and no folder. I write it. How can I go in this? Because it automatically mounted. When you write it, it automatically mounted. Now then you can run a command df-kh. You can see here. Yeah, it automatically mounted. ls, right? Test file is also there. Okay, let me log out this system. Oh, for example, oh, I have a tea break. I'm going for, you know, I log out this system for 20 seconds, right? Like it's 56, 57, 20. 1, it's, you can see the timing. We have to just count 20. And 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 11, 12. Okay, now I'm going to. I'm going to again save my session. It's 70. I'm okay. You can see, gone. There is no mount point. And when you access it again, you can see there is no directory. Again, when you will share df-kh, wow, the directory is also there. And here you can run any command, make directory, altm. Right, what is there? Let me go on my client server, and in my server, right, file is there, right guys? Okay, this is we have to configure. I already show you, add a start, this is restart, enable service, okay. To verify, I already show you df-kh command. You will see there is no mount point. Kindly use a command. Right? Thanks to watch our video, guys. Hit the like button and give your comments and suggestion. And subscribe our channel, Technical Tech, for get latest video updates. Thanks to watch our channel.